man by the name of Milton Hall was shot 40 times after he went through a confrontation with police officials there. They shot at him 46 times, and he suffered 40 gunshot wounds. The question is, should they have shot at him? Now, we do have video explaining this story in greater detail, so let's take a look at that.
Anger and impatience growing tonight in Saginaw, Michigan over the fatal shooting of a man by police officers. The shooting was caught on amateur video, and we're going to play it for you. And I have to warn you, it's very graphic. But we're going to show this video because it reveals how police handled what has become a controversial case and a major issue in Saginaw. Some residents are disturbed by how the man was killed. At least 30 shots were fired at him.
If you listen carefully, Hall is then heard continuing to yell at police. Hall seems agitated.
He even dialed 911 himself.
And I have my knife out. I'm defending myself. Sir, you gotta put that knife down.
After failing to disarm him, police shoot Hall. A total of 47 shots were fired.
Who do you believe? Who do you believe in? Is it Buddha?
The tragedy of his death and how it happened, how they circled him and assassinated him, and he had no idea that those policemen would do that to him. One policeman, after he's on the ground, turned him over, handcuffed him, and put his foot on his back. And that's in the video. And his blood running down the street like water. And he wasn't a threat. I mean, he had a little pen knife.
Now they shot him about 15 times.
The confrontation between six Saginaw police officers and Milton Hall, a 49-year-old man who his family says suffered from serious mental health issues. Hall, seen in the middle of your screen, police say, had just had a run-in with a convenience store clerk. He was in a standoff with police and holding some sort of knife. Then, as Hall appears to take a few steps, everything comes to a head.
So many times.
I don't know, man.
That's a straight up fool.
They killed
that
nigga.
Man, they shot him about 15 times.
That's what you got overkill, man. That's overkill.
Local media report 46 shots were fired. CNN counted the sounds of at least 30 shots on the videotape.
46. That's the number of times six different police officers shot at one man back in 2012. That man was Milton Hall, a homeless mentally ill person whose crime was pulling out a small pocket knife. Now, at the time, the shooting, thought by many to be an example of excessive force, sparked outrage across the country. During the standoff, a dog lunges toward the 49-year-old man, and he pulls out a small pocket knife. Hall then turns to the dog, and that's when police open fire, striking him a reported 14 times. At the time, the Department of Justice opened an investigation into the incident. However, that investigation was closed in February after the department said it could not find, quote, sufficient evidence of willful misconduct on the part of the policeman.
There's insufficient credible evidence to criminally charge any of these officers with a crime arising from the death of Milton Hall.
Anthony Baber witnessed the shooting.
All of a sudden, pow, 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 pow. And he drops. You know, pow, 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 pow. And he drops. I was about where that blue van is. I was parked in my van.
Tabitha Perry saw it too.
And do you believe the officers were justified in what they did?
No, I don't. No, I don't. Because what they did, there was a better way to do it. I think their judgment was off.
Perry is not alone. Hall's mother says Saginaw police overreacted.
Emotionally, I have a lot of pain, and I'm stunned that six human beings were standing in front of one human being and fired 46 shots. I just don't understand that.
On the day of the shooting, July 1st, the Saginaw police chief defended his officer's actions.
This is someone that, from our understanding, has a long history, not only with police from our department, but with the county, known to be an assaultive person.
Over the last month, members of the community have voiced outrage about the Hall shooting, not satisfied with the police investigation into the officer's response. We showed the video of the shooting to City Councilman Norman Braddock.
I can see why people are traumatized at looking at something like that. And we need answers.
Hall's mother already feels she knows the answer to the question of whether police used too much force.
It appeared to be a firing squad dressed in police uniforms. And there was another way. They did not have to kill him.
So to have eight people to stand in front of one human being and shoot at him 46 times and hit him 14 times, it's been devastating to our family. It was devastating to the community, to everybody. To change those kinds of things that's happening in this community and other communities with the assassinations and murder, it starts at the top. When you have the U.S. government who go in and look at something for 4 or 5 months and then come out and say, well, it wasn't intentional. It's given me a commitment for the little time I have left to work with parents here who their kids have been killed similarly. And justice still has not been served.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, dear nigga down here, before I proceed, tell me if you believe it.
Mothers in black crime, brothers in packs done, plus everybody's high, too doped up to ask why. Watching our own downfall, witness the end. It's like we don't believe in God, cause we living in sin. I asked my homie on the block, why he strapped, he laughed, pointed his pistol as the cop called, passed the blast. It's just another murder. Nobody mourns no more. My teardrops getting bigger, but can't figure what I'm crying for. Is it the miniature caskets, little babies? Victims of a strength from drug dealers gone crazy. Maybe it's just the drugs. Visions of how the block was. Crack came and it was strange how it rocked us. Perhaps the underlying facts they hide explain genocide. It's when we ride on our own kind. What is it we all fear? Reflections in the mirror. We can't escape fate. The end is getting nearer. Who do you believe in? I put my faith in God, blessed and still breathing. And even though it's hard, that's who I believe in. Before I'm leaving, I'm asking and grieving. Who do you believe in? Who do you believe in? I put my faith in God, blessed and still breathing. And even though it's hard, that's who I believe in. Before I'm leaving, I'm asking and grieving. Who do you believe in? Close my eyes, cause all I see is terror. I hate the man in the mirror, cause his reflection makes the pain turn realer. Times of Armageddon, murdering mass amounts. In a society, we're only getting the cash counts. I started out as a beginner, into the criminal lifestyle, became a sinner. I make my money and vacate, evade prison. Went from the chosen one to outcast, unforgiven. And all the Hennessy and weed can't hide. The pain I feel inside, you know, it's like I'm living just to die. I fall on my knees and beg for mercy, not knowing if I'm worthy. Living life thinking no man can hurt me. So I'm asking before I lay me down to sleep. Before you judge me, look at all the shit you did to me. My misery, I rose up from the slums. Made it out the flames in my search for fame. Will I change? And I'm asking, who do you believe in? I put my faith in God, blessed and still breathing. And even though it's hard, that's who I believe in. Before I'm leaving, I'm asking the grieving. Who do you believe in? Who do you believe in? I put my faith in God, blessed and still breathing. And even though it's hard, that's who I believe in. Before I'm leaving, I'm asking the grieving. Who do you believe in?
Faith in Allah, believe in me and this plastic. Cause so far I done witnessed too many dead niggas in caskets with they chest plates stretched like elastic. And what's worse, I'm on front line, holding down camp, still mashing. Heard my cousin, one of the old heads from the block, just came home October 95, back in Yardsville, stuck with a 3-5 if he don't act up. Now he realized if you don't stay wise, then in this game you fuck. Talk to my baby girl, give me the word on what she heard. One of the grimies, a snitch and diamond, a stew pigeon. I talked to him, he said he did. My man said he did. In fact, he's sure, cause he just came home off a bed.
Now tell me, who do you believe in? I put my faith in God, blessed and still breathing. And even though it's hard, that's who I believe in. Before I'm leaving, I'm asking the grieving. Who do you believe in? Who do you believe in? I put my faith in God, blessed and still breathing. And even though it's hard, that's who I believe in. Before I'm leaving, I'm asking the grieving. Who do you believe in? Who do you believe in?
Who do you believe in? Is it Buddha, Jehovah, or Yah?
Before I'm leaving, I'm asking the grieving.
Is it Jesus? Is it God? Or is it just yourself? Definitely not to be imposed on being a demon. Because this is the joy of believing in, to believe in yourselves. But for sure, the higher power resides only to ride in the heart of the truth. From the soul of the man, for truth never has an alibi in the poetry or in its realm. That's what pulls all words together, just to understand that every man is his own man, and only man can satisfy the man. Only the soul of the man, the feelings of the man, the fulfillments of the man. You can't shake the man when you feel the man. You know the man, and you gotta call yourself because you are that man.
Who do you believe in? I put my faith in God, blessed and still breathing. Who do you believe in? Who do you believe in? Put my faith in God. Believing, before I'm leaving, I'm asking the grieving. Who do you believe in? Who do you believe in?